this House needs to know first. I find it totally unacceptable that once again, that we see Downing Street running roughshod over members of Parliament. We're not accepting it, and I'm at the stage where I'm beginning to look for other avenues if they're not going to treat this House seriously. What I would say is I think it's time for me to have a meeting with the Prime Minister to actually put on the record, here now, but with him, that this House matters. Right. Further to that point of order, Ian Duncan-Smith.
Just in case there was any lack of clarity, Mr Speaker, from your statement, is it at all feasible that should the government now have recognised the power and force of your statement and that of the objections of the House, that they could now change and come to you, Mr Speaker, and say that they are prepared to bring that statement forward so that it was held at 6 o'clock? Would the House be able to find time for that, Mr Speaker?
If somebody is willing to do that from Downing Street, I will always ensure that this House will hear it. My view is I was told no decisions have been taken. That's why I'm more shocked to know there is an embargoed list of what's going to happen to this country without this House knowing. I was told no decisions have been taken, that no decisions will be taken until the Cabinet meets. The fact is I am being misled. This House is being misled. It is not acceptable, and I would welcome them coming here before they make the press statement, as the press have already got an embargo. And I'm sure now that the whip is texting the chief whip to let him know exactly what's being said, because it's disappointing to all of us. I'm now suspending the House for 3 minutes to enable the necessary arrangements for the next business to be made. Order.